Ladies and gentlemen, it's time to learn Redux. It's a brand new series that I'm starting, or you can call it as an extension to my previous series on React, because it's important to learn React before you even start Redux. So what are we gonna learn in this series? We're gonna learn what Redux is, how it works, why we use it, how to work it with React, how to set up the store, how to combine multiple reducers, what is middleware, what is Redux Saga, what is Redux Thung, and all the other related topics on Redux. So that what will make you a great React program. So in this particular video, we're going to learn what is Redux, an introduction to Redux. Anything that you try to learn, the first thing you need to do is try to understand why are we learning it. What problem is trying to solve? So that's what we're gonna do in this video. And welcome to Texas Tutorials. All right, so to start with, what is Redux and why do we use it? I think a lot of people make this mistake when they learn React and when they start learning Redux by just coding, they get really confused because if you start using Redux in React project, without even thinking how it works, it will just confuse the heck out of you. And I know a friend who did that and he was like, I love React, but I hate Redux. And that is because he didn't understand. Redux is so simple. If you understand, it's fundamental. It's so useful. You're gonna love it once you really understand it. So let's try to understand what Redux really is and what problem it's trying to solve. First of all, Redux is not part of React. Redux, at least not right now, while I'm making this tutorial. Redux is a separate JavaScript library that you can use with or any other JavaScript framework for that matter. So what problem it tries to solve? It makes the state management much easier in React. Why is it hard to manage the state in React? From what we all know, if you have learned React, if you build a project, it's pretty simple, right? You can just pass the data via props and action and all that stuff. It works quite smoothly. So why do we need Redux for it? Well, when you're learning, you build small examples and passing, props and all that stuff is very easy. You feel like you don't need anything else. This should be working. But when your application grows to a certain level where readability comes to an issue, that's where the Redux comes in the picture, where it makes your life much easier. All right, so let's look at this page. It's a container. You can call it a one route, let's say, where you have state called age. So it just basically have a primitive type called age, a number, right? And in the page, you have multiple components, and your components have components, and there is a nested component hierarchy. And at the end of it somewhere, at the bottom, you have a button, which when you click on it, it increments the age. Now, you have to pass all the stuff around from the component as a prop and, from one to another all the way to the deepest level where you're actually using it, right? Now it's easy when you have like a one simple component, you might have to pass other props and everything. But in a complex application where you have to pass a lot of things, it becomes really difficult to manage. Quickly, things can get out of control. Now let's look at another scenario where you have two pages, or you can have multiple pages, lots of pages where you wanna share the same state. You have to probably pass, because they're containers, you have to pass through some query parameters, or something like that, right? Which becomes very difficult. So you need a simple way to solve this problem, right? Now, what are the things that you can share with, like, for example, let's say you logged into your page. So you verify it through the server. Now you need to save that information that you already logged in, and then you wanna use it across your pages. Wouldn't be better if there was a one global variable that manages it, so you can access it anywhere from your application? Yeah, that would be great. And that's where the Redux comes in the picture. Now, you must be like, okay, is managing something globally isn't like an anti-pattern? Because we've been told not to do anything globally, right? When we do JavaScript or even framework I remember when I started learning Angular, the root controller, should I say, and it was kind of bad, right? Bad practice, and people told me that this is a bad idea. And yeah, it was a bad idea. But in this case, it's a good idea because the way it's done, okay? It's not just some variable that you automatically access it from everywhere, okay? You can just pass it around. It's done quite nicely, and you're gonna look at it in a minute. And also, in the next tutorial, I'm gonna show you in a code, but I think it's important to learn it fundamentally before you even start coding, because that's a mistake a lot of programmer makes. The best way to do it is have a global store where you can have a state and where you have the your age, right? Now you can manage some of the state, or you can manage the state of your entire application. Now, what are the things that you wanna manage in a store, and what are the things that you wanna manage globally? So for example, let's say in this page, you have some modal, okay? When you click on a button, it opens a modal, and you wanna manage if it's open or not and all that stuff, right? So that is only limited to that page, so you wanna manage inside that page, not globally, right? But let's say if you have a data for the entire page, you wanna manage it globally, so you can access it globally. So this is how it works. So let's say if you have two pages and I wanna increment the state from both pages, and I also wanna display it in both pages, right? So the first thing I wanna do is I wanna have a store where my state is located, the global state, which can be shared by all the pages. Another thing is if I wanna update the state, instead of having those functionality inside all the pages, move that functionality into the store as well. And that is called reducer. So reducer basically holds functionality to modify the state. Anything that you wanna do, let's say you wanna increment the age, decrement it, whatever you wanna do, right? You can manage it through reducer. So how does this whole thing work? So let's look at an example. Let's say if you go to your ATM machine, you know, to deposit some money or take the money out, right? To do a withdrawal. Now, your ATM machine not gonna have the functionality of how to, you know, add money to your account or how to withdraw money, right? It should be very simple, right? If every ATM machine holds that functionality, it becomes very complex. You need to put that functionality somewhere in some central place, right? So the ATM machine should say, hey, increment by $25 and to this account. And then the central place would basically take that command and then do whatever it needs to do. And then once it's updated, it should come back to that ATM machine, right? Saying, hey, it's updated. And so you see the real amount. So that's the concept we use here. So from a page, I click on it, it dispatches an action. So what is an action? Action is, think of it as a command. So in this case, it's this command. Basically, it sends an object over to the reducer. And the command has two things, the command name, so which is increment this or decrement this, right? So that's called type. And then the second thing is a payload. Payload is, okay, increment by this value to this account or something like that, right? So that's a val. And you can have other properties as well. And what happens is when a reducer receives this, it checks if it has this type. If the action type exists, and then there should be some functionality inside, which basically takes the current state, creates a copy of it, and then modifies that state according to the functionality. So if it's incrementing, it adds one to the age, and then it sends the state back, and then it updates it, right? So it's similar to how React works pretty much in that sense, where you basically don't mutate the state directly. The beauty of this thing is once the state is updated, so there is a subscription model. So anything that is subscribed to it would receive a message, or basically there's some function that it runs and you can get a new state from there. And then you can it updates all the UI. So that's how it works in a nutshell. All right, so that's about it, folks. This is how Redux really works. And again, in the next tutorial, we are going to build a very simple example only with Redux. We're not gonna use React still. We're just gonna look at how Redux works, because you know Redux can work in isolation. It doesn't need actually React with it. And I would highly recommend you just go through it before even you integrate with React. If you want to follow the entire series, please bookmark the playlist. I'll provide the link here. And I hope you learned something from this tutorial. And if you did, please like, subscribe, and provide constructive comment. And you can also help the channel via Patreon. Also follow me on the Twitter and the Facebook. And I have a new thing. I'm creating some merchandise on a Teespring. And if it's available in your country, feel free to purchase it if you like it. It could be a great gift for somebody. I'll provide a link here. And you can also translate this video for me. Provide the information in the description. And thank you.